My name is Dave Perlick.
And I'm Jillian Perlick.
Together we've been operating Region Kitchen and Bar for the past 2 years. The last few days in March that we were able to operate, we were cautiously optimistic that we would continue to serve, but then there was a notice that all restaurants and bars and other food service establishments would be closed down. And honestly, it was shocking. We didn't know that we were gonna open back up within the near future, maybe a couple weeks, maybe a month. We might be shut down entirely.
It just felt like everything we worked so hard for had just been ripped out from underneath us.
Every morning, my wife and I would sit and talk, just trying to put the right pieces in place to serve our community, to serve our employees.
We just thought we'll take the couple carryout orders, and we found ourselves drowning and the phones ringing. And we thought, oh my goodness, we're gonna have to bring in staff and provide, this is great. We can provide to-go meals, and we figured it out, fine dining style.
We've been at Harvest for 12 years now, so we've been able to meet and befriend many people. And the Small Business Directory definitely led a lot of local church members to come and dine at our establishment.
Even the amount of emails and text messages we got of just, how are you guys doing? We're just like, you know, thanks for reaching out. Even that in itself was nice. You know, people were thinking about us, and you know, somebody from the church even sent in just a monetary gift for us, just for us. And we felt at that point, we said, oh my gosh, that was so great, but we're doing okay. So we actually took that money and brought food to the Harvest food drive. We were also presented with providing meals for hospital staff. Lauren Hills from the Shepherd Circle organization reached out to us and said, we want to give back to restaurants that have donated to our organization in the past, and we want to give people the opportunity to help hospital workers and purchase meals from your restaurant, you know, so that we could make a little bit of money in this time. And that actually blew up.
Exponentially.
Yes, we actually had more meals bought than workers were employed at the hospital for that shift, so we had to do multiple deliveries over a couple weeks, and it was such a blessing just to be able to do that, you know, to help.
It's kind of a boomerang effect, you know, where mm-hmm. we just, as you know, the Lord loves a cheerful giver, we were blessed, and we decided that people out there are struggling to survive, and we just tried to, we never stopped our tithing, we never stopped our giving, we only increased our giving. And I believe with my whole heart that the Lord, He blesses those who sacrifice. And for us to funnel blessings towards people who need them in different ways, that's something that we will never change and only strive to increase in our relationship.
And now we're in what, phase four, and we're half capacity inside, just about. And ultimately, with online ordering, outside dining, inside dining, we feel like we're back at a normal rate, just a little bit different.
God always has a purpose for what may come to your front doorstep. I would ask that this restaurant would be a mission field for the gospel, that people would see Christ in me, Christ in my wife, and ask questions and want what, you know, has been so freely given to us, we would love to share it with other people.